Hey, what's up guys? Thank you for tuning in. Today's video, I'm going to be taking a break from the Kingdom line to take a look at the new Transformers Studio Series 86 line. This is Hot Rod, or at least Voyager Class Hot Rod. This does look like an instance if you're going to have a slightly upscaled deluxe and a Voyager Class box, so hopefully you're okay with paying that price. If not, you don't got to buy it. Nobody has a gun to your head. You can see a lot of his accessory goodies in there, and then his box art looks beautiful. They have the 86 tagline right there, because this is G1 in the movie line. I know a lot of people have an issue with that. I think a lot of this, honestly, is War for Cybertron or Earthrise Kingdom Runover that they wanted to allocate somewhere, and they already have this toy line that they've really blown through a lot of characters. So I have no problem with them allocating some to 86 as long as we still get some of those necessary movie guys. So with all that out of the way, I'm gonna go ahead and tear this guy open. I'm super excited. Let's take a look at him. And here we have Hot Rod out of his box. Now, I do want to go ahead and establish something. Usually in my reviews, I am pretty positive. This is an instance where I have to not be overly positive because I am absolutely in love with this figure. I don't know really what it is exactly, but I am head over heels for this. I feel like I really might have already found my Transformer of the Year for 2021 3 days in. But again, I'm going to try to not just gush for the next 10 minutes over this figure, but let's go ahead and get into him. So I want to go ahead and get him like compared with his freaking animation model. Like, oh geez, like I don't know how they did this. Like, he just looks so perfect. He looks so great and so good all the way around. Like, there's no car, there's nothing. Like, G1 Hot Rod's design is already so sleek with not a lot of car parts, and they outdid themselves beautifully. I'd like to go ahead and get him compared to his 06 Classics counterpart. Here is the original Classics Hot Rod and the new one. So here you can see how they stack up. You can see, you know, the past like 15 plus years of advancements in technology. And just look at that. That looks wonderful. This one was never meant to be the most animation model accurate, so I understand. But holy crap, just look how far we have come. This looks wonderful. I love how they look together. I still love the 06 Rodimus. There's something chunky and really fun about him, but just oof. And to also get him compared with his 2017 Titans Return figure. Again, you can see how these guys scale up. They're both basically deluxe class as far as modern standards. So if you're looking for something that kind of has more of a sharp edge to it for more IDW, you can go with this. And you can get the head off of Shapeways. Or again, if you want G1, you can just go with this. So, and I do not have the Masterpiece figure to compare him with, because honestly, after I have this, Masterpiece who? Hot Rod's accessories are very fun and plentiful. He has his two little pistols, so you can just plug these into his hands, which are articulated. Open them a little bit and then close them around it. And he can hold both of his guns. So I'm just going to go ahead and plug one in there. The other thing he comes with is he has blast effects. You just want to take his arms here, rotate them at the shoulder. I mean, you can pose these however, but I'm going to make them look like he did in the movie. Just want to pose these forward. Don't mistransform it. And you just want to plug these. They plug on in here in the center one. And where is the other one? There it is. And there you go. So he has blast effects, so he can shoot at the Autobot shuttle. That's full of Decepticons. I promise it's full of Decepticons. And yeah. Ooh, and then the other fun thing too, this isn't really much of an accessory, it's more of a feature. But if you take his head and gently open it, kind of want to grab this up in here with your nail, because I'm afraid that'll break. It is just thin translucent plastic. It doesn't feel like it is, but you know, just in case. And you can fold that forward, and he has his visor. So, I mean, like, look at that. This is a retail Hasbro figure that I bought at Target. Like, what? And he can do all this? This is crazy. He also comes with his saw blade so he can hack up some Sharktacons. How you attach this is you come up underneath the hand here, you pull out that panel for rotating out this peg, fold it back up, and then you just use that 5mm and it's pretty tight. You can just wiggle out on there. And now he can hack up Sharktacons. Like, again, there's not a lot he doesn't come with. I feel like the only thing he isn't coming with is, like, the fishing rod, which, like, come on, DNA upgrades, let's get on that. The other thing he also has, another fold-out feature here. In this hand, you do the same thing. Rotate this this one out here. And he's got his little soldering thing, so he can fix cup, too. Like, again, there's really not much, especially from the 86 movie, that he doesn't come with. Like, I know, I'm already gushing, I'm sorry, but just look at that. Last but not least that he comes with here, he does come with a little matrix. This is just a recasted matrix from the Earthrise Prime. I was a little disappointed at first because he cannot store it in his chest the same way Optimus can, but then I realized this is Hot Rod, not Rodimus, so hey, that's fine. And he also comes with this effect piece, so this is really, really cool. You just take these two little clippers here on the back, and you just plug them over the cask of the matrix, just like that from the back. And now you can put it in his hands and he can light the darkest hours. So let's try to do this on film. Now his hands, you can see here, he doesn't really have a way to hold the Matrix a lot like Optimus did. So Optimus, I just had him kind of one-hand it, cradle it. He has to kind of open it. So let's see if we can... So you kind of got to wedge it in his thumbs and his index fingies. He can't just, like, put his whole hand around it. But you'll see a better shot of that later. But, yeah, he can kind of hold that Matrix just like that to light our darkest hour. This is so cool. Hot Rod does have some fantastic articulation. His head joint, he can go up and down that much. This boy can rotate 360. Also, his shoulders. Again, his joints are very tight, so let's try this. But his shoulders can rotate 360. They're going to get knocked by the fin back there. His arms can go in and outward at this upward hinge up here. His elbows rotate 360. You get that much bend out of them, so very, very nice. His hands can swivel 360, and you can see the hinge in there for the fingies and for the Matrix holding. So he does have articulated fingers. Again, retail Hasbro toy. What? Okay, I'm sorry, but like, ugh. With this cuts up here in the thigh, his legs can go way up high, then go back an okay amount. The legs go out that much. They rotate 360 at the thigh. You're going to get a double jointed knee, which is gorgeous. And then also you're going to have this ankle pivot. So you can go forward and backward. And then you can also get this really nice sideways. So there is no shortage of articulation on him. He can do damn near everything you would really ever want a Hot Rod or a G1 Hot Rod to do. Robot Judd Nelson here does have a very fun and very interesting animation accurate transformation. So let's go ahead and get to it. Vehicle mode, and I love this vehicle mode. Again, it looks like it's right out of the cartoon. You probably noticed during the transformation sequence, but the way the shoulders like come out and rotate around and then flip back around to become the front of the car, it's just right out of the cartoon. I love it a lot. So here we're going to go ahead and get him compared with his 06 Rodimus counterpart. Here you can see this guy is just freaking huge comparatively, but whoops. And yeah, again, this one was never meant to be super animation model accurate. I'm not comparing them for that sake, really just because it's a classic Rodimus versus a classic Rodimus. And then for another one, let's get his Titans Return buddy in there. So these two kind of match up a little bit better. I really like this car mode still. I think this thing is gorgeous. The spoiler and everything out, the way it all tabs in is super solid. So if you're interested to have a more IDW looking Hot Rod, you'll probably want to go for this one right here. Again, if you're looking for G1, go for this one right here. Now again, I guess let's find out a few things that I don't like. Let's not gush too much. This yellow up here, some people have really pointed out, kind of takes you out of the vehicle mode. I could see that. It'd be nice if that was red, but hey, the bottom here, you can see all the robot mode junk, which is fine. It doesn't stick out or anything. It's just such a clean, concise little car. The other thing, too, is how these transform his exhaust pipes. If I can... These right here. So that middle one, you can see how tight they were for me to get out. But that middle one right there has a little bit of a lip to it. This one tends to break off on some people's copies. This is not broken on mine, obviously. But just a heads up for that. It's just one of those tabs that's a little too secure. It's nothing that'll destroy the figure if it comes out or breaks. Now, also here, you can take his effect parts for his exhaust guns, and you can just plug them directly into the exhaust part of the vehicle. Whoops, if I can do it. So, he can, you know, hot rod around, like, sure. The other thing as well, if you want weapon storage, you can go ahead and take his guns up here. They have two little fins on each of them, so you just plug them into these slots on the engine block with the pegs facing outward. And you can get the guns on there. Now, this kind of reminds me of, like, a Target Master-looking hot rod. But it's really funny because they also instituted this right here. So you can go ahead and use these two tabs up here to plug in the saw. Oops, if I could even get it. There we go. The saw blade. So I don't know what he's hoping to accomplish with this right here, who he's trying to kill, but I wish him luck. Now, the thing with the saw blade weapon, at least with the vehicle mode storage, I've only done this twice, once for playing and one for this video. And when playing with it, there is a really gnarly, it's not focusing, there is a really gnarly stress mark already forming right there. So I don't really recommend you do that if you don't, you know, want to stress that. And I'm not really worried about it breaking, I just think it's ugly, but it's really not detrimental. But just a heads up on some of those stressing tolerances. And that's pretty much all I got to say about Hot Rod here. I think he's fantastic. I think he's absolutely phenomenal. I think he has a few hinky issues with some of his tap tolerances, like right here, and with this stress mark right here and the saw blade bit. But I don't think it's anything detrimental. It's nothing that's really going to destroy the figure for me, and nothing that I don't feel like it's going to implode and kind of combust into a pile of plastic on my shelf in a few years. So if you guys have any questions about this figure, maybe something I did not cover in this video specifically, please feel free to leave a comment in the section down below. I'd be happy to get back to that as soon as possible. Please like or dislike this video, depending on if you enjoyed this content or not. Subscribe for more, and I'll see you guys next time. Thank you for watching.